Good morning. It's Tuesday, December 8th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled Shade for Mount Zion, and our scripture is Isaiah chapter 4. But in that day the branch of the Lord will be beautiful and glorious. The fruit of the land will be the pride and glory of all who survive in Israel. All who remain in Zion will be a holy people, those who survive the destruction of Jerusalem and are recorded among the living. The Lord will wash the filth from beautiful Zion and cleanse Jerusalem of its bloodstains with a hot breath of fiery judgment. Then the Lord will provide shade for Mount Zion and all who assemble there. He will provide a canopy of cloud during the day and smoke and flaming fire at night, covering the glorious land. It will be a shelter from daytime heat and a hiding place from storms and rain. When you live in a warmer climate, shade is a wonderful thing. Earlier this year, the two churches I serve decided to meet jointly outdoors. Both churches are in a rural location and have exceptionally large oak trees. The shade was more than welcome, especially to the preacher. The parking lots became our sanctuary, complete with folding chairs, coolers full of water bottles, and fans. But there's no substitute for shade from those gigantic trees. In 2007, I went with a group for a short-term mission to Zimbabwe, Africa. We were building an addition to a Bible college in the middle of nowhere. Trees were in short supply there. The only reprieve from the scorching midday sun was to go inside the existing building and collapse on the hard, baked dirt floor and enjoy the shade, which was only 105 degrees, which seemed like 205 when you factor in the flies. Well, Isaiah points to a portrait of God's shabby, sin-scorched condition after the fall of Jerusalem. Jerusalem, including the temple atop Mount Zion, is destroyed. But God promises restoration. God himself will complete the cleansing and be a shade for everyone who worships him. He's the shelter from the daytime heat and a hiding place from storms and rain. These are metaphorical images of God's protection and provision. It's God taking care of God's people. There are many scriptures that describe the arid, parched condition of a land or a soul that's forgotten how to worship God. For many of us, baked in this COVID season of doom, this image is our focal point of rescue, our rest within a weary land. Isaiah's pictures begin with a statement, "But in that day." As with the other prophets, Isaiah speaks of Israel's restoration on a local level, that which pertains to his time and the conditions he sees with human eyes. At the same time, his words are inspired by God for a meaning beyond what the prophet can see. The ultimate meaning of God's prophecy through all the prophets is God's final move in history, the eternal move which results in total and permanent restoration of God's people. The prophet points not just to a rebuilt temple with bricks and mortar, but a temple and city made without hands, God dwelling with God's people. He points to a new Jerusalem and the perfect reign of Christ. This is the eternal shade for Mount Zion. This is God's heaven. For you today, times are tough now. People are suffering and tempers are flaring and the climate is more than a global warming. We are in a scorching season. For those who follow Jesus Christ, this is no time to join the negative voices of doom. This is a time to look up, for your redemption is drawing nigh. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.